be where initiates undertook their final preparations.
Deliver the Night Mother's mercy upon her enemies. Trust your secrets to the night. Shroud yourself in blackest night.
Descend to the night song. Make a sacrifice. Rise again. A dark justicia.
Almost there. I will not. This must be the last step. I need to pray. Only by Lady Shah's grace did we even make it this far.
Slip into Shadowhearts, but you are not the only one present. There is another, ancient, commanding, rendered from purest darkness. Shah.
Take my spear, step forward, and strike down the Saloonite.
As you command, Nightsinger.
Now go. Warm my blade with moon-crazed blood. And be wary of your companion. He pries in your thoughts.
That wasn't for you to hear! It's simple. My Lady Shah demands a sacrifice. One life. Not that it matters, but her reward aligns with your own interests. Remember what I said. Let me do what I need to.
Your party is gathered. You are ready, or so you hope. As you step into the silent water, a foreign dread travels through you. It curls its way up your leg, squeezing tight.
I can feel her all around. This is her domain. This is the Shadowfell.
You did well. Better than I would have credited you with. Now, hurry along and bear witness to my masterpiece.
This is the Dark Lady's domain. He does not belong here.
Simple. I followed you. It seems Shah still holds a grudge against General Thorn, and so sought to prevent me from entering in his name. Luckily, you were the perfect agent in helping me slip past her defenses. Now the Night Song is within reach. Your lack of ability, perhaps? You made for an adequate errand boy thus far, but let's not overstate your virtues. Raise one finger to me, and I'd sunder you like lightning would a rotten oak. Now, enough dullard questions. Follow me.
I feel lighter, unburdened, as if the softest push could send me drifting away.
Lady Shaw, hear my words of faith. Blessed Night Singer, witness my adoration.
Kill her. Listen to her.
I have emptied my heart of falsehoods.
Descend.
I have vanquished your foes.
Listen.
Maybe there. Have to keep going. Lady Shaw's wall shall be done, as sure as night will fall. Lady Shaw's will shall be done, as sure as night will fall.
To lead this would-be Justicia's blade directly to my heart. I invite you. Heap more sins upon your head. My retribution will be all the sweeter for them.
All this time, and you still fail to appreciate the gifts I bestowed on you, Aelin. Sad. To see a thing of beauty not recognize its own worth. But General Thorne, he appreciates you, and he wants you close at hand. So, I am here to whisk you back to him.
Cetheric. I welcome the sight of him after these 100 years. He whose immortality I supply with my very soul.
General Thorne. I'm sure you'll be on your best behavior for him, but just in case, I've taken some precautions. Keep back. It will take quite some concentration to secure Aelin for her little journey. Person? Please, you insult her. You insult me. Aelin is so much more than that. She is an Asimar, bound to a soul cage of my creation, and lending her immortal strength to General Thorne. Her power, his will, and my genius. An unsurpassable feat.
Ramblings most unsane. Poor Balthazar. For maggots ate his brain long ago.
Hold your tongue, Aelin, or I'll take it away from you again. And you, no more questions. No more interference. Paying attention, have you? Perhaps I'll revive your carcass and add you to my retinue. Then you'll have all the time in the world to think on your mistakes. Let us make short work of this.
Thank you.
from here. Another step forward. Gone with the weave.
Faith will
press ahead.
Balthazar has drawn his final rancid breath. A pity it was not my hand that brought it about. Instead, it was you. You, who have come to seek the praise of your wicked goddess. You, who have come to drive a dagger through my heart.
Not a dagger. A spear. My Lady Shah's spear. Her fate is mine to seal. Let me handle this.
The fate you seal is your own. To be a Dark Justiciar is to turn your heart from everything but loss. You will know no love, no joy, only servitude. Until, of course, your mistress inevitably discards you. And there is much she does not tell you. A terrible blood price that may extend beyond my own death.
You feel Shadowheart bristling. This is important to her. But your bond is strong. You may yet be able to sway her from the path of duty to the path of light. And Nightsong is not blind to your conflict. Behind that raging heart is the restless beat of one who knows too well. And her fate hangs in the balance.
I did that. Shah will disown me. Now I'm truly lost.
You were already lost, little warrior.
A lost child, frightened by wolves.
What did you say?
Much has been promised to you, hasn't it? But what has been taken from you? What do you know of your own heart? Your own life? Lay a hand on me in friendship, not quite surely. And I will fight the battle that has been waiting for me this last century. Then, oh then, we will have much to discuss. Silver, hear me. She who guides the moon maiden Saluna, mother of the so-called Night Song. The Night Song is no more. Given me a great gift, little warrior. Don't you find it also curious that you would spurn your dark lady? Perhaps you feel a stirring of the truth already. But that will come later. There is a battle yet to be fought. You have done what we feared was impossible. You have released me from a century of sorrow. Your power is great. So too must be your weapon. You must choose what you will wield. And the Moon Maiden will provide. Thus I have said. Thus will it be so. Are you ready? To kill Ketherick Thorne.
Shah won't stand for us to be here, not after what we did. That's what frightens me. She must be angry. Yet, I don't feel it. Or hear it. There's only silence. Let's get out of here, please. Whatever's coming, I don't want to be in the heart of the Shadowfell when it finds me. The Night Song will be headed for Moonrise Towers. We'd better get there and see what she's unleashed against Ketherick Thorne.
Well chosen, Shadowheart.
not helped.
Shadowheart, what happened? You were missing for a moment.
I thought I was done for. I thought perhaps I might have been dead. This is all like some sort of terrible dream. But it's real, isn't it? I stood before the Night Song. I heard Lady Shah's words. And I failed her. Worse than failed her, I defied her. Just because of what that Asimar said. I tried to leave, but Shah blocked me. Punished me for failing her. I thought I knew the limit of pain that the incurable wound could inflict, but I had no idea. It felt like I was suffering the agony of 1,000 people all at once. My blood was boiling, my hair was on fire. I thought I'd claw my own face off with the pain. But then she released me. Banished me, more like. She said I was an outcast. That all of her children would know me and revile me.
Shadowheart looks distraught, abandoned by her goddess and all former allies. And as for her divine magic, admitting who empowers her now may break her spirit for good.
You're lucky to have such confidence. Me. I think the full price of what I've done has yet to reveal itself. I'm a target to Lady Shah's followers now. Night Song promised she'd tell me something about myself. I need to speak with her as soon as I can. What she said to me back in the Shadowfell about the wolves, that's no coincidence. She took flight to hunt down Kethric Thorm. All I can do is help hasten his demise and hope that answers soon follow. Do you really need to ask? I'm sorry. I have a lot on my mind. The Shadowfell, Night Song. I can think of little else. That's not the first time you've made such a leap. I don't know. Maybe it's a Saloonite trick, or another way for Lady Shah to test my faith. The sooner I speak to Night Song, the sooner I'll know what the future holds for me. Assuming I have a future at all. I'm sorry. It might be best kept until later. I'd be a poor counsel and worse company just now.
Poor Shadowheart. The gods are nothing if not vindictive in their vengeance.
Shadowheart.
Shadowheart suffers. You might be surprised, but it pains me to see. Now, what would you ask of me? I'm listening. Exquisite, isn't it? The pain is a mutual promise branded on our flesh and bone. Inside your every wound lives my obsession. Inside my every wound lives your passion. You are Jacques Vonashdu, source of my bruises. I had the audacity to invite a man of your talents to strike me. You had the courage to stand against me, unflinching. In so doing, you made yourself my possession and my obsession.
A private word would be nice.
I'm sorry. It might be best kept until later.
Speak your mind. I'm listening. I'm listening. Here. Now. If it weren't apparent, it should be. I'm not keen on such outward displays of our flesh bond.
I'm ready.
Let's move.
Unshackled from shadows. She will rise in moonlit glory and carve a path of brightness to the accursed one's second death.
So saith the wise Alondo. That beacon of angelic wrath has taken the fight to Catherick on the rooftop. In the first line of defense are dead. But storming the tower won't be easy. And if we wait too long, Catherick will gather his strength and retaliate. For now, though, he's on the back foot for the first time since he returned from the grave.
This is it. The spearhead moment. You brought us this far. So how shall we proceed? A sound strategy. Once it's done, me and my harpers will hold the ground floor while you hunt down the general himself. Floric left some of her flaming fist. They'll scout the prisons and the barracks below to ensure we're not taken by surprise. Say the word, and we're off. At the ready, harpers! In this light, there will be victory. In this light, we will avenge the fallen! The time has come. Getherick will taste of death at last. Soon we find the reckoning. Once more into battle. Once more to save Baldur's Gate.
What's hiding here? Swift as my feet can carry me.
It's a grim task, picking provisions from the dead. But the way I hear it, the fighting's not done yet. You need to resupply. Lady, light your way. Just tell me what you need. Lady Light away.
My blade will taste of your flesh. I'm so set on a century old scorpion.
You dare show yourself here after all you've done? You have betrayed me, you have betrayed General Thorm, you have betrayed our god! And for what? These harpers. Moonrise will be their tomb, and in death, you will all serve the Absolute. Where's the fun in that? Boys, make this traitor bleed. On the move.
At last.
We shall not fall.
Strip your bones clean!
Thank you.
move.
Smear your entrails
from these walls in her name.
On I go.
Boscura!
I am fury. I am death. My path be true.
Onward.
Someday I'll catch a break.
There's a parasite in that corpse. Let brimming none escape with potent to warn the magic.
Army. Not until we put Ketherick down.
What's inside?
Just tell me what you need.
Lady, light your way.
There's no time to waste. Assume nothing.
Ready and willing.
Securing. Positioning. Let us have words.
Just tell me what you need. Lady Light away.
I'm ready.
What do we have here?
The rummage.
Let's get going. What's in here?
Just tell me what you need. Lady Light away.
I have no time for small talk.
As long as we hold this floor, the tower is ours. I'll stay here, ensure no one comes up or down without a scimitar welcome. You're close now. A final audience with Ketherick Thorm awaits. May you strike like the viper and choke like the vine. Good luck. The last dynasty of thorns shall be